should call this video Welcome to Jenny's Shame File. I went to pull out some of my albums of 2014 to have a bit of a flick through, and guess what I found? The majority of my pages haven't been put into albums for 2014. And look at this. If I perhaps pull this up, you might get a little bit of a inkling as to how many pages I have actually made that have not made it into their homes, into their album. So I'm going to give you a quick look through, and I'm going to have a quick recap of 2014. So for those of you who don't know, which I haven't really shared that much about, I won a competition in 2014 with a magazine here in Australia. So it was a national scrapbooking competition. So it was run Australia-wide, and 10 people were lucky enough to be chosen as winners of this competition, and I was one of them. So very, very blessed indeed. And what that meant was for the whole of 2014, guaranteed that every single month I was published in a magazine, and I got free product to work with, etc., etc. So I'm actually thinking that I'm going to do another whole video on that and show you all of the layouts that I made for that magazine. I didn't like them all. Sometimes, you know, if you're given product that you don't particularly like, it's really hard to work with. But that was a challenge. So, you know, our title was Scrapbooking Master. So, you know, as a scrapbooking master, you've got to be ready to be able to create, you know, anything. So I'm going to give you a quick recap of some of these ones. So this one was in the magazine, and this was using stamping as a technique. So all of those feathers on the background are actually stamps, as well as that feather there, little feather set. So that was a part of a challenge. And this one was as well. This was using one of the hip kits, and this was using smaller photos as the main focus, and so I actually just used the little print off that they gave you at the shop. And this was another one. This was with a die and embossing folder. So the die was these Polaroid frames, and the embossing folder, don't know, there you go, you can see that that's all embossed, and it was using Project Life cards as well. This one here wasn't in the magazine. That was just a layout that I had made using various supplies from my stash. And this one was in the magazine as well. And that was some pink paisley, some Heidi swap. So I was using different pieces of stuff from my stash, but I'm going to go quickly so we're not here forever. And Project Life cards, using them in a non-traditional way. To move that, and that was using a Heidi swap Amy Tangerine piece, and that was using half of it as white and half of it as a color. This one here, the dreaded Christmas look, and the thicker has fallen off. Merry Christmas. So this was the paper I had got given. This was the one I had to use. You know my love-hate relationship with Christmas paper, and I don't like this. This would be my worst layout I think I've ever made, but we will move along. So this was using, Maggie Holmes. A Maggie Holmes collection, as was this one. And this one was inspired by Erit, and using the rub-ons and the plastic technique where you spray. And I think I used distress stains, so you spray them on the plastic and rub them on, and then I used all different rub-ons from my stash. And this one has a process video. That was the more recent one that you've seen. This one has a process video that's yet to be processed. You've seen that one, using the Amy Tangerine. This one is yet to be published, so that there's a process video for that. There's one for that one as well. And this one, so any of these, you can go back and have a look in my process video folder. That one has got one that's coming, that's been published. That one's up. So is that one. That was a challenge that I gave myself to use a feminine line in a masculine way. And that one has got a video. So all these pretty much have a video, unless I tell you that they don't. So that was using, these ones are using Kelly Perky, called Second City, I think that collection was. And they all have videos. So as you can see, this year was pretty productive. I think this was one of my very first process videos. You might remember that actually this one was the very, very first one that I did with my iPhone and had the black bars up the sides from holding it wrong. So these are my first process video layouts. And I think that we are getting into where I have done my layouts for hip kits. So I think this little pile that I'm coming to now are layouts that I've done with my hip kits of varying various months. So these are the Christmas ones that I've just done. This one's yet to be processed. That one's there. Love that one. That would have to be one of my favourite ones. Still love that. So these are all hip kits. So just gives you a bit of a look of what you can do with your hip kits. I think that was a hip kit, but with a piece of paper. It was getting towards the end and I've added another piece. So just gives you a bit of an idea of what kind of layouts you can make with them and, you know, what kind of products that they have in them. And love that picture. Just going to pull that up. Love that picture of my son. Makes me laugh every time. He's hilarious. And look at him there trying on the hat in the shop. I think this one actually, I've made this one a long time ago, but I don't think I actually have put the video up yet. So I have to have a look at that. And so hip kit. All of these are the beautiful hip kits, which I could make a video on, I guess, just by themselves. But hopefully this isn't too long. We're only at 8 minutes so far. That's not too long. Love that one too. That was for my daughter's 18th birthday when we went out for the day. And so as you can see, I don't journal on a lot of them. You know, I think sometimes the little pieces, you know, say what I want to say. And, you know, the memories are there for me. And, you know, my family, they remember what they are, so. And sometimes I do journal, or I journal on the back. So these are still hip kits. So as you can see, I love my hip kits. Never dissatisfied with them. And, you know, really enjoy using them. Find that they are really versatile and always different. And I have made a lot of layouts. This isn't even the ones I've put in the album. So I'm impressed. I thought I was only at about 20. Obviously I can't count. Alright, so I really love this one. This was lots of fun, using up all the little bits and pieces in the little packs, the little button packs. Has had all little bits of pieces in there, and I decided to use them on the one layout, and that was just lots of fun, that one. Using up lots of different frames in ways I might not have done before. So what I like to do is I actually like to just challenge myself often to scrap in ways that are different all the time. So, you know, each album, that each page that I've shown you, is they're all different. So, you know, do I have a certain style? You know, I don't know that I do. Do I scrap in a certain way? Not always. You know, sometimes I like to do mixed media. I've been heavily with mixed media, and, you know, then I've steered clear of it. You know, I've done lots of times where I've done lots of layers, and then there are times where I've done them really simply. So, you know, I love to challenge myself, and I love to use the pages, I guess, in, yeah, like I said, ways that I wouldn't conventionally use them. I like to use product that I wouldn't normally necessarily pick for myself, and I like to just try things different. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they are more simple, like that one, and like this one here, letting the background speak. So sometimes I've got really busy backgrounds, like that one, and then there are times where, you know, the background, like that one, you know, is being the background, and it's letting the photo speak. There are times where I've got lots of layering happening, and then other times where I've got very few layers happening. There's times where I've got lots of tags, lots of, you know, building up of product, and then there are times where I've just used mixed media, or I've used, you know, three photos in a row. I think I usually love one photo or maybe two and work around a square. So lots of different techniques. Sometimes I've used just white. I have times where I just want to use white cardstock. And then there are times like this one where, you know, I just loved using the bold background. Still done lots of layers without it being overwhelming. And then there are times where I love to cut the pieces of paper apart and actually really enjoy piecing them back together in a way that they weren't intended to do. And, you know, some, this one here, wild, that's a wild layout, but, you know, it's still awesome. So I had this paper that I was challenged by, this grid design on the back. It was such a challenge, but I love doing it. You know, it was so good. And so this is, you know, the 10 things that I love about you. And so I've numbered all the little bits and pieces about my kids when they were little, what I loved about them, and used different pieces from different collections and made them, you know, work. You know, this one here was using, you know, this beautiful blue chevron piece of paper that, you know, is so bright, and the yellow is so bright, but when you put it all together, it looks awesome, and there's all different things from different collections in there, making it work. You know, grabbing my old stash. So I've got a mixture of things that are old, products that are old, and products that are new, and I'm still, you know, making them work for me. You know, just because a collection is older doesn't mean that it's outdated. So, you know, this one here, this was a part of a prize that I won. Didn't particularly like them, but I love the way that looks, that page looks. You know, simple. And you'll see my black splats, you know, quite often repeating themselves. But, you know, they're all different. I think that's what, maybe that's my style. My style is that they're all different. You know, they're all different, and you can't necessarily pin me to one thing. I like to do lots of different things. I like to use older collections. I like to mix it up with newer collections. I love new things. I love, you know, these ones were very simple, keeping it very simple, adding some watercolour, you know, bright colours with watercolours, you know, happy photos. I think they're just happy papers, I call them. Papers that I love to work with that make me happy. You know, I love this one of my daughter with her friend. You know, it's all old, random bits and pieces of stuff that I pulled from my stash, you know, that work. There's me, don't really like the florals, but, you know, hey, that one worked and had a purpose. There was a message in there, and touched a lot of people. You know, it's a good thing. And, you know, trying different techniques. I'm getting back to the start again. I'm just, you know, just showing you that they are all different. They're not all the same. different techniques, different things being showcased. And I really love that one of my son. Love, love, love. Handsome boy. That was his 16th birthday. You know, and that's what scrapping does for me. You know, I look at the pictures. I love the creating of the background. I loved this one. I don't know if you can see that with the date stamp all over the back. I'm not sure who did that, whether it was a person in Nicole Jones 911, but it was someone else that I need to give credit to. And, you know, I just love that about scrapbooking. I love that I get to be creative and create something that I visually really love and look at, but I love that I get to look at the photos, and I, you know, as a mom, I get to remember, you know, what my kids when they were young, and, you know, I get to revisit places that we've been to on holidays, and I just, it evokes, when I look at these pictures, it evokes happy memories for me and happy times, and even in times where, you know, there's some hardship and perhaps life isn't going the way we want it to go, you know, there are still good things happening in life, and life is still good, you know, and we choose to look at the positive things that are happening. We choose to always look at the positives, not the things that could be classed as negatives, and to just move forward. And so, you know, when I look at this big pile, you know, there's happy memories in there. There's happy times. You know, I've enjoyed the scrappy, happy time. And I've also, you know, got some, I'm going to drop all these. I've also got some beautiful memories happening as well. So I'm going to leave you there, and thank you for spending this time with me. This is, you know, 17 minutes long or so, and I really appreciate you looking at some of my pages over the year, and I look forward to bringing you many, many more. So I will see you next time. Bye.